Hi, everyone. It's meteorologist Justin Stapleton. Thanks for jumping on to clicktohouston.com. We've got a stormy week coming up here, courtesy of this big area of low pressure that was on the West Coast, bringing that 7 to 12 feet of snow across much of the Sierra Nevada mountain range. That's now moving eastward, and it's going to be shifting north-northeast. It's drawing in two different moisture sources from right here in the Gulf and out towards the Pacific as well. Now, the majority of the real nasty weather, you can see this watch box here, that's for severe thunderstorms. That's all going to be north of us, but cold front attached to that will get close enough that I do think we're going to be looking at a stormy couple of days as we get into next week. A little bit of a dry pocket there also sliding in behind now. That'll kill most of our rain chances, I think, for the rest of this evening. But as that storm gets closer, we'll see more of those fire up as we've got a very kind of moist, unstable air mass over top of us right now. So let's take it hour by hour as we roll through the rest of the night tonight through tomorrow morning. Fairly okay. Some spotty showers out there. Nothing too major. But as we get into the afternoon, the heating of the day, I do think we'll see some thunderstorms start to develop, and that front stretches right outside of I'd say Tyler Lufkin as you go southward towards San Antonio. Now watch by Monday afternoon overnight into Tuesday. That's when we'll see that front start to slide southward, and do expect to see a chance for some scattered thunderstorms. Could be some strong ones as well, as that line will be approaching, kind of slicing its way right across the metro area by about 6, 7 a.m. and then hold there for most of the morning before it lifts back northward as a warm front. Another system comes in behind that. That one also is going to be a pretty good soaker for late Wednesday into Thursday. So how much rain could we see throughout most of the week? Well, right now it looks like we're painting kind of a broad brush here, anywhere from around 2 to 3 inches. Spots that get hit multiple times could push that upwards of around 4. So we'll have to continue to watch for any localized flooding. Right now, lightning, obviously one of the threats that we're looking at, heavy rain potential in some spots, some strong wind with those thunderstorms. Hail and tornado threat right now, fairly minimal, as this will mainly just be a big rainmaker over the next couple of days. So we'll keep the temperatures in the mid to low 70s, that is, over the next few days as well. It's going to be stormy out there for the afternoon Martin Luther King Jr. parades, and then same thing, strong storm starting on Tuesday, just some scattered showers on Wednesday, then that next system slides through. It's going to be a fairly soaker of a Thursday, and then we'll dry out on Friday, Saturday into Sunday. You know, some weak chances for rain showers, but actually a little bit of a cool air push behind that for both Sunday and Monday. Highs will be back into the 60s and overnight lows down into the 40s. And right now it looks like we might even try to grab onto winter by the time we get in towards the end of the 10-day as well. That's your forecast from right here at clicktohouston.com. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'll be jumping on there live a little later on this evening. We'll time out your storms for you as you head towards your Monday morning commute. And you can get your weather needs anytime you need it. Just come right here at clicktohouston.com.